and what does it mean for you to be a part of this year's Fright Fest?
Oh, I'm thrilled. Absolutely thrilled. It's the first time I've ever had a film in Fright Fest. You know, most of the films I've made have probably couldn't be categorised in the horror genre in any way at all. I think what we've made, Dark Tourist, is probably on the fringes of the horror genre, certainly probably a crossover into other genres. So to be invited to what I believe and see and can feel is, you know, one of the most exciting and popular and you know, has to be places. I'm absolutely delighted. I couldn't be more delighted. And the festival have been genuinely fantastic, fantastic hosts to me and the actors and everybody who's been involved. So really thrilled.
Obviously, as you kind of alluded to there, the horror genre is one of the most diverse, I think. But what do you think it gives an audience that they don't seem to get from any other form of cinema?
Fear. I mean, it's a tricky question, that, because I'm very kind of anti-genre in this sense, that I think that once you start to divide things up, you kind of miss some great opportunities. And it's the films that exist in the margins that are in slightly in the wilderness of genre. You know, say David Lynch's films. I'm a big fan of David Lynch. Are they horror films? Are they surrealist films? Are they drama? Are they fantasy? What are they? Which they don't really. And I think that the most exciting movies, you know, exist on the in the margins. So whilst, you know, horror to me means, you know, fear, scared, you know. But if it comes from a real psychological place, then I think that's what excites me, I suppose.
About your own film, Dark Tourist. I mean, like you say, it flirts with a few different genres, but can you start by just giving us a basic synopsis for people who haven't seen the film yet?
I'll give you the briefest synopsis I can, right? It's a dark film about a tourist.
A little more than that.
It's a dark film about a tourist. But that is, I mean, it's a glib thing to say, but that is what it is. It's about a man who, on vacation every year, chooses to go to the sites or scenes of past horrors, past either tragedies or disasters, or in the case of our film, to retrace the steps and the haunts and the childhood home of a infamous serial killer called Karl Marsnap, who's a fictional character, but he killed a lot of people in a church, including his parents. So it's about a man who gets excited by visiting those places. And there's a reason why he gets excited, because there's a very dark place inside him. And that is what the film sort of, the layers unpeel, and that's what we discover as we go through his journey on vacation. I think it came from two places. One is to really look closely at and put a mirror up to a sensationalist driven society, and particularly media, but also to look at what happens to people who fall through the net of either community or family or society's care and protection, and where, you know, what happens to them if you don't, you know, put sufficient attention into, as Jim Tanner in the film would say, into fixing them. And one of the things that he expresses in a agonizing, you know, animalistic scream at one point is, why didn't anyone bother to fix me? And he's desperately in need of that. And I think a lot of people in society are, on a serious level, desperately in need of help and fixing in some way. And we walk away at our peril.
Talking about help, how much of a help was it for you as a director to have the cast that you've assembled? I mean, particularly, Melanie, I think, obviously an actress that people will recognize, but perhaps not in this type of film and not in this type of role.
Yeah, it was a very brave choice, I think, for Melanie Griffith, because for two reasons. First of all, she hadn't done much work in the movies up until our movie. So she spent several years, you know, taking some quiet time off to contemplate, you know, what her next sort of acting role should be. But I think the other reason why she was brave was because this is a character who has to be both, you know, appealing and repulsive to our main character, Jim Tanner. So she has to play a range of emotions, but also looks. So she has to, you know, become, you know, very real. And for her to embrace all of that and become part of our team as a proper actor was just, you know, it was invaluable to have her on the set and have her experience, and also particularly, of course, her acting ability. Mike Cudlitz is an extraordinary actor. He's an extraordinary man, but he's an extraordinary actor first and foremost. His performance is you know, speak for themselves. He puts everything into every role he does, and he certainly did with this film. But he's not just an actor. You know, he's a producer on the film. He was on all the technical recce, the scouts, at almost all the casting. He was involved in the post-production, the editing. You know, and he's been an ambassador for the film, not just as an actor, but as a producer as well. So to have that sort of commitment from an actor, you know, he put his life into it. I'm not a dark tourist, you know, I'm not the kind of person who would, and I think a dark tourist, by the way, is not just someone who visits the scenes of tragedies or disasters. I think a dark tourist is someone who slows down at the side of a road accident, you know, or who thinks that they're going to pay their homage to, John Lennon because they visit the spot where he was killed. But I also think a dark tourist is someone who sits alone at home and watches 24-hour news and hops the channels when the happy stuff occurs. You know, so what makes people that? I don't know. I don't know whether it's driven by the media or whether the media are leading. In other words, whether the media are leading it or whether, you know, society's thirst and hunger for those kind of things are driving the media. I don't really know the answer to that. I believe there's good in all of us. I believe there's darkness in all of us. And I guess at one level it's a relatively harmless sort of fascination that we have, you know. I mean, I've read books about some dark stories, dark subjects. I've had some dark thoughts, you know. Of course we all have. But it's when you start to express those in a wider society and you sort of somehow make society kind of indulge and spend time celebrating in some strange way those things. That's when you got to start to question yourself. And that's why this film is, I think, very important. Message to horror fans. Here's one for a cozy, warm Sunday afternoon.